sometimes finishing it. It's funny, in the middle of my day, I don't want to sound like some old fogey. Although I'm beginning to feel like an old fogey sometimes. But, wound up taking a nap. Just pain and suffering and kind of some of the aches and issues that I have for health. I got, I guess, worn out from sharing and doing the word and writing some really good material on the web. And when you pour out your soul, so to speak, you give of your emotions and of your strength even. And whatever you do, we're told to do it heartily as unto the Lord. And when I do, it takes a lot out of me. And so, sure enough, I fell asleep for about an hour. Well, actually, I think I fell asleep for probably 20 minutes, but felt like an hour. And it's different, I gotta admit. But I get up early and stay up late, so sometimes a nap's good. For all you old folks out there. Starting your day, stay stable. The uncompromisingly righteousness shall flourish like the palm tree. Be long-lived, stately and upright, useful and fruitful. They shall grow like a cedar in Lebanon, majestic, stable, durable, and incorruptible. Psalm 92:12. James 1:12 says, "Blessed, or oh how happy, is the man who is patient under trials and stands up under temptation. For when he has stood the test and has been approved, he will receive the victor's crown of life which God has promised to those who love him." Don't get upset if somebody gives you a hard time today. Don't get upset if you don't get your way, or if somebody says or does something you don't like. If you are set up for an upset, stay stable. It is only a test. This is a test of the emergency broadcast Christianity. For the next 60 seconds, Satan will try to tempt you and blow you right out of the water, so you'll lose your cool, lose your grace, lose your mercy, lose your love, and just act like a pagan. But the reality is that we go through these things to temper us and to bring us to a inner strength that we don't react, but rather, when we fall into a circumstance, we stop for a moment and then choose to act based upon information that we take in, resolution that we resolve within ourselves to not react, avocation of whichever we are. Say we're a paramedic, we obviously respond for medicine. If we're a minister, then we share the word of God. But also by our invocation of bringing God into the picture, by invoking that calling out from within you that Jesus should take over for you the circumstances of the life that is involved and you're involved in. Because then, if you ask God to help, he can turn the circumstance upside down and use it for his glory, and you receive a reward for being dependent upon him. It's too easy to react. You don't have within you the ability to do that. The challenge is to not react. That's the first step, to let that first reaction pass you by without participating in it. But the second step is to act and to do something. And in my case, my action is always to turn to God with whatever it is, rather than react and turn away from God and turn to myself for what might be the exaggeration of what is happening at the moment. Since God looks on the outward thing, or man looks on the outward things, and God looks on the heart, I think our reaction ought to be to turn to God so that our action could be godly. Don't you?